Hi there, in this lesson, you will learn about what is Karnaugh Maps, sum of products versus Karnaugh Maps, rules of interpretation for Karnaugh Maps, and instructions on using Karnaugh Maps. Then, we will look into some examples of Karnaugh Maps, and finally end with special K-Maps arrangement. So, first of all, what does Karnaugh Map do? It creates a Boolean algebra expression from a truth table. And the main benefit of using Karnaugh Map is making the process much easier than if you use sum of products to create minterms. If applied correctly, a Karnaugh Map produces the simplest possible form for the Boolean algebra expression. Let's look at the difference between sum of products and Karnaugh Maps to understand better. Let's look at this truth table here. By using sum of products, we will get x is equal to not a dot b plus a dot not b plus a dot b. It's pretty straightforward. We are just forming the equation based on the combinations that results in 1 in the truth table. But we can see that this is not the simplest form. So we have to simplify the equation. So after multiple steps of Boolean simplification, we will get x is equal to a plus b. So this is quite a tedious process, and we might make some errors during the simplification process. And now, let's look at using Karnaugh Maps instead. We will first create a table with A on top and B on the side. So on the first box from the left is when both A and B are 0. And the last box from the right is when both A and B are 1. Then, we will find the overlapping section whereby the value is 1. So we have one circle here and another circle here. Therefore, solution is x is equal to a plus b. We will talk more about the rule and instructions of using Karnaugh Map in the next few slides. The purpose of this slide is to show you how powerful Karnaugh Map is compared to other methods like sum of products. Now, let's talk about the rules of interpretation for Karnaugh Maps. First of all, only consider cells containing a 1. And next, identify groups of cells containing 1s, which can be a row, a column, or a rectangle. And then, ensure groups containing a power of 2 number of cells, such as 2, 4, 8, and etc. Then, make each group as large as possible. We can also allow groups to overlap and ensure all possible overlapping groups are utilized. Furthermore, treat individual cells that cannot be included in any group as single cell groups. Finally, within each group, retain only those input values that remain constant across the entire group. So, these are the rules that we have to know when we use Karnaugh Maps. Of course, it looks a bit complicated now, but later on when I go through the actual example, you will understand better. Let's look at the simplified 3 steps instructions on using Karnaugh Maps. We have a sample truth table here. So, step 1, circle all groups of 1s. Using groups that are powers of 2 and use the largest group possible. So we have one circle here and another circle here. Then we eliminate all variables that are not common in each group. Let's say for the green circle, we know that we can eliminate C and D variables since they are not constant. And for the purple circle, we can eliminate B and C variables since only A and D remain as 1 in the purple circle. Finally, we can combine all the groups using the plus, which is the OR operation, resulting in x is equal to AB plus AD, which is also equal to A bracket B plus D in simplified form. So, this is how you can use these 3 steps to form the Boolean expression using Karnaugh Map. Once you know the hang of it, it's actually quite straightforward. Now, let's look at one Karnaugh Map example that I took from the partial question. First of all, they'll give us a Boolean expression to complete the Karnaugh Map. It's actually quite simple. You just have to put the value of 1 for each of the combinations. For example, we have this Karnaugh Map here. For the first expression, which is not A, not B, not C, not D, it will be at this position here. Then, we can repeat this for the second expression. And then, third expression, fourth expression, and then fifth expression, and then the last expression. Finally, just fill the other empty spaces with 0 here. Then we can just repeat the 3 steps that I mentioned in the previous slide. So, first circle and then second circle, resulting in this equation here. Then, we can simplify the equation using the bracket here. So, the final expression will be z is equal to not c bracket not a plus b. So, this is how you can answer typical Karnaugh Map question. Before we end, let's look at some special K-map arrangement. The first example will be this one here. Combining the left and right will result in Z is equal to not B here. The second example will be this one here. Combining the top and bottom will result in Z is equal to not A, B, not D. And then the last example will be this one here. Combining all four corners will result in Z is equal to not B, not D. So that's all about Karnaugh Maps. I hope you find this video helpful and it helps you with your studies. If you are eager to dive deeper and master Cambridge A-level computer science in the shortest amount of time, check out my full program at www.hagrin.school. Thank you, and I will see you again then. Bye-bye.